And now, backstage with Steve Rizzo.
Happiness is a choice. That's it. It's a little secret indeed, isn't it? But it's a great one. Listen, happiness is a choice. As I always say, making happiness a choice is what life is all about. And it's the best way to stay motivated throughout the day. So, I know, like right now, I could hear you thinking, well, if happiness is a choice, then why are so many people feeling crappy instead of happy? Why are so many people going through life feeling unfulfilled? The answer is that most people either don't believe that happiness is a choice or they can't understand its meaning. As Abraham Lincoln once said, people are about as happy as they make up their minds to be. And this is coming from a man who had to deal with the weight of an entire fractured country on his shoulders. Okay, so what does it mean happiness is a choice? I think people can reject this notion out of hand because it's so simply phrased.
Oh, you mean that's all I have to do is make a choice and presto, I'm happy? Give me a break, Sparky.
No, that's not what I mean, and don't call me Sparky. Happiness isn't one choice, like deciding which presidential candidate will make you less miserable or picking between chicken and prime rib. Instead, happiness is one long, continuous choice. Now, if that notion is too daunting, try looking at it as a lifetime of small, moment-to-moment choices. Listen, on any given day, there are a number of reasons and excuses I can use to justify being unhappy. I mean, it could be work-related, family issues, and believe me, folks, if you knew my family, you would understand. It could be time constraints or someone else's bad mood. The key, the point I'm making here, is that I know I'm responsible for my own state of mind. I'm totally aware of what happens to me when I begin to lose the thread of that control. Allowing these outside forces or circumstances to determine my happiness can quickly send me in a downward spiral, and that's not going to be healthy for anyone. The same goes for you. Whatever it is that has the potential to keep you from enjoying the day and the success that you desire, understand that it's not the situation that's causing you to be unhappy or to feel unsuccessful. It's really the thoughts that you have about the situation that makes the difference. It's what you choose to focus on over a period of time that will fuel your emotions and define your reality. You know, I find it absolutely amazing that the same incident can be experienced and interpreted in different ways by different people. I mean, there are those who view life's little mishaps as a major catastrophe, while others find the humor in them. Some people would have their day ruined if their car didn't start. I mean, these kinds of people have a tendency to intensify their problems by continuously rehashing their woe is me story to anyone who will stand still to listen. Now, don't get me wrong. That's not to say that you're wrong to get upset when your car doesn't start and you're not going to be on time for work. I mean, that's natural, of course. But you're doing yourself an incredible disservice if you allow that bad mood to continue. If you're not vigilant, one bad mood can snowball out of control and ruin what could otherwise be an enjoyable, productive, and happy day. Ralph Waldo Emerson had it right when he said, "To different minds, the same world is a heaven and a hell." My point is that rather than dwell on the negativity, why not choose to shift your focus and way of thinking to what's working in your life, to be grateful for what you have, and to use your time and energy to find solutions to your problem? I mean, if you do this, you're going to be experiencing a happier, healthier reality for yourself. Either way, the outcome is based on choices. Choose to be happy now. It just makes sense.